we will continue with our stock monitoring system. As you can see, we've done already how to add stock in and stock out. Again, we'll process stock in. If we will select, so this particular ID, it will give us, so this quantity, I will add 50 and stock in, it will become 100. If I remove 25, it will show also the quantity on hand, 75. Look. So this is our transaction. Here, stock in and stock out. We'll modify. It should be here. We'll modify to descending so that the last transaction it will show up. Clear again. We'll type this item, stock in 25. Lock this one. 25 stock in. Then we'll select another item. So whatever our stock in and stock out transaction, it will automatically log into our transaction history. So say I will remove 25 stock out, lock here. So every time our transaction automatically, it will goes to our transaction history with a specific time. Now we need to add some form or code. Let's say if we will select this one, then we will double click. Automatically we can edit this particular item. As you can see here, we cannot edit because here is locked. This is just only to show whatever we select here, but we cannot input or modify. So we need to add code in order to edit or modify the details in particular item. Okay, design view, then here we will select this list box. This is search result, then go to event, then we will use, instead of on click, we will use double click. Otherwise, if we will like this one, if we will put on click, whatever we select, automatically it will pop up the edit form. So we need to choose here double click instead of on click only, because again on click is just only to select, and we can see the specific items to process our stock in and to process also the stock out. Okay, I will select, then go to double click. Here, I will type dim is the doc name as string, then dim is the link criteria, so we will put our criteria here, criteria as string. Then our doc is the doc name, so we will open our item details, this one. So So if we will double click this list box, automatically this form with a specific item code will pop up, and now you can modify the details. So I will select and press F2 so that I can copy. Then again, I will go back to our code here. Is the doc name, then equal the double quote, then we'll paste that form, then double quote. So now we have the specific form to open. Then we will use this still link as our criteria here. Then I will put double quote. Now our field, which is the product ID. So this is our criteria. Whatever we select this list box, so if we will select what item, so whatever ID for that particular item, it will open accordingly. Product ID, then equal. Now we will concatenate from our list box, which is this, our list box search result. So this is the name of our list box, me, open bracket, then our list box. So whatever we select into our list box with the specific product ID, then this form will populate here. Whatever the our criteria, it will populate inventory details with this particular product ID. So now, since we already concatenate with our product ID, which we select on our list box, which is search result, then we will put code do cmd dot open form. So we will open form. So instead of writing our form name, we will use this one, stdoc here, do cmd open form, then we will use the string, then comma, then we have a condition. So this one, this is our condition here, our still link criteria. So again, whatever we select on this list box, it will populate here based on this link. And now we will execute this form to open. Okay, we'll close. Then if I select this one, so there's no any form, so we just select, then we can do our transaction. However, since we already put some code, if we will double click here, automatic, it's blank. We'll check product ID, should be double click here product ID. This is the wrong. This is the issue. That's why it's not showing the specific item. And here we need to put and, since we will concatenate this our product ID and our list box. Issue. Then here I will remove this one. Okay, so that's the issue. Double click. Now it's okay. If I select here, now we can modify. We can change 26. Then we'll save. And here also we can add new. So now we can modify items. Let's say 1946. Then double click. Then we can modify the item details. Then we will add also another button here. I just select, then go to home, format printer. Then we just modify this one, then add new, then here CMD new, so that if we will add new items, so no need to go here and double click, then click add new. So we can use this button to automatically, if we'll click add new, then this particular form with the blank, so that we can enter our new item. I will put here the top. So add new. Then I will put code here on click. Then do CMD that open form. So we'll not use the link, so we'll open form normally. So inventory details, then comma, another comma, another. So no need to put some condition because we will open our form in normal. But here up form add this one, so we will choose, so that if we will open that particular form, it will go to the new look, as you can see here, because we will open directly. So whatever the first items in our inventory, it will show here. So since we will use this add new button, so if we will click this add new, it will show us the blank. Okay, look, if I click add, now blank. I will type sample only, then 10. Here I disable this text box so that whatever entries, it must be recorded with our history, because if I let this text box enable, so if someone will put some entries, so you cannot track the transaction. That's why I put this one as disable. Now I will save. Then you can process that inventory. So we need to refresh. So just F5, I will select okay sample, so we can search here sample. So now if we will double click, still quantity on hand is 0, but you can add inventory using our transaction, so that every transaction have a transaction history. Now, since we already select this item, then we can add an inventory of C100, then click stack in. So now we have a transaction history.